Hello, folks. Welcome to the Truck and Duck Show. This is my Wrangler 2002 CJ. I don't guess it's a CJ Wrangler Apex. Those big new tires I just bought. This is a park like this is an old train tunnel, 200 years old, dug out the way they did John Henry, the steel driving man, did. Picks and axe and shovels. It's about 300-400 feet long, and it's people still use it every day. Drive bus, school buses, and everything through it. This is a park. It's called Red River Gorge. They more camping areas around here than you can shake a stick at, and they still building them. People in the mountains. Like me, they go to flat country like Florida and oceans and Texas and stuff for vacation. People in them places come here for vacation. This is famous for rock climbing and kayaking. And everywhere you look, they tents in the summer. They one business store, a grocery store, a restaurant that's probably 50 or 100 tents behind it. I don't know, they tents everywhere. But that's the tunnel right there. It was built 200 years ago, and this is in the snow. We got ice on the road, got snow on the road. And it's a little dangerous. As you can see, it's straight over the mountain there. Yeah, it is there, Rusty. You better be careful. Just one slip could kill us there, Rusty. I've rode my motorcycle through this road hundreds of times. Beautiful place to ride. Right here's one of the old style bridges. They ride the kayaks down to about here, and they load them on a wagon, and they haul them way back up the river and let people ride them. And you can turn right here and go right on down left here and go way on down towards another city. But right here where you turn right here, you're getting into the Red River Gorge Park. You see that sign there? They got a campground right here. This is a new campground. They've got bear, they got mountain lions, and they got all kinds of stuff down in here. They got garbage. You have to lock your garbage cans. They got a lock and garbage can stuff keep the bear out and stuff. A tent don't hardly seem like enough for me when the bear's around, but everybody's to his own self there. You think the road's slick? I see it. No, I ain't gonna kill you. But, yeah, this is a nice place to hear. The people lived before you get this road a little bit on the main road. They chopped firewood and set it out in front of their house and sell it to these people that comes in from out of state. Sell it to the people by the armloads or whatever, make a fortune off of firewood. The river over there on the right is the one they ride the kayaks down. I don't know where they get in. Way up through here somewhere they get in the kayaks and go all the way down the river. That train tunnel, I think there was two or three people got killed building it. It's got a big old billboard up there. It tells all about how long it took to build it and all this kind of stuff. That's right, if you stop and read it, you learn all about it. Yeah, that big old cliff here, that stuff called Chimney Rock and all kinds of stuff that you probably won't be able to see. Big rock mountain over there to the right up on top of that hill there. See how the river twists around down there? It's a pretty good ride in a kayak, I guess. I've never done it. I bought the tires for the Jeep just today. The tires was wore out, so I went and had a new set of four big new mudders put on her. Bring her out in the snow and and see if she slips and slides. So far, no slipping, sliding, or spinning, so that's all right. Well, if he did slip, slide, and spin, turn over that bank, we'd be out of it. Told you to wear your seatbelt, Ralph. Never ride around without your seatbelt. Nah, those things bother me, Rusty. Those things bother me. You fellas say that seatbelt's bothering you crazy. All it does is lay on your shoulder. Can't bother you too much. Nah, it bothered the heck out of me. Come to think of it, that one in my wife's car kills me on the passenger side. It tightens up on your shoulder and it will not release. You have to stretch that thing out there and hold it out there a mile. Once it tightens up, it's got you. I hate that thing. See how twisty that river is over there, folks? You barely can see it down that hole there. A creek, river, whatever, going around them turns under this cupboard here. Man, get hung in his sky and get killed there. This old road leaning sideways right here would be a good place to slip over the mountain. Yeah, it would. Yeah, it would. They're rusty. You want to get out, Doug? I my feet cold. Feet cold. Yeah, that's snow. That's the first snow we've had, I think, about 2 inches here. Now, this straight over here, you got to be careful, people. People usually park in little wide spots up here in the summertime. Any little wide spots you see, like anywhere, like right in here, they park there and they'll tent. They'll put tents down all down under the bank here. It's like a little city up here in the nighttime. Amazing little place. I don't know how many ambulance runs they make a day up in here to get people that's fell off these cliffs, that climbs these cliffs. They come in from all over to climb these rock cliffs. That one over there on the right, that big one up there, I'd say many of people's climbed it. Climbing the cliff's just not my thing. You know, if I get up on top, I'll look over, or down at the bottom, I'll look up, but I don't want to climb a thing. I see they make tents nowadays. I've seen on TV that you hang on the cliff and just sleep in the tent way up in the air. Yep, that's just what I'd want to do. Man, go for a sleepwalk, get wake up in a hurry, wouldn't he? Yeah, sure, but I don't know what married Federal Rusty. I guess they like the thrill just like you used to like the thrill getting out on that heavy equipment there, Rusty. I'd say you're right, Ralph. Red River Gorge, you can look it up on the internet in eastern Kentucky, Red River Gorge. Plenty of walking trails, plenty of wildlife. It's got a thing up here called Sky Bridge. We don't get out and walk to it, but we can drive to it. We can drive to where you can't see it to turn around at the end here. Sky Bridge is a natural rock that looks like a bridge. They two of them here. One's called Natural Bridge and one's called Sky Bridge. You can walk across it, then they got a... You can walk down in the hole around it, around behind it, and walk under it. Then they got a wooden staircase coming up the other end. It must have 500-600 steps coming up it to get back up out of that hole, and I can't go down there. I used to go down there, but I can't no more. But man, it takes a long time climbing all them steps to get up out of that hole. I can still see the river over where the old kayakers would be paddling down through there if it was warm enough. This Jeep's got a straight six cylinder, 5-speed standard shift, hard top, with heating and cooling, good cool air and heater, 10-ton winch on the front, and I just put a LCD lap bar on the front the other day on top of the winch. So when we go through that tunnel, it lit it up good. And them cliffs right there, them ain't big enough for them fellas to climb, I guess, but I guess they start up there. Beautiful place in summertime when it's all green. That little bridge up here somewhere with the parking place right at the end of the bridge. And that's where they used to have buffalo down in that hole there on the right. these fields up here down at that level, and they kept the buffalo down in there. It come a flash flood one time and drowned two or three buffalo, and they moved them all out. So there's no more buffalo in here. They used to roam these fields here, so you could drive through here and check out the buffalo. So that's all changed now. I never camped out here a night in my life, but I just live 20-some miles away. I don't need to camp here, but a lot of people do. There's no one in park signs. Tell you in a Kentucky state park. You have to have a pass on your car, a permit on your car or something, if you're out in your pass like 10 p.m. or something. If you're going to stay all night, you have to have a permit. Now, right here is a place over on the left where you used to pull off and park so you could get out and look the buffalo over down in these fields off the side of this bridge here. Both sides of the bridge had fields going up, and down beside the bridge they had 20, 30 buffalo roaming around in there. Nice spot. Yeah, it was. I seen by riding one of them rugs, and I got up close to him, seen how big he was. He shook his head at me, and I shook him my head at him. And I decided his head a lot bigger than my head. And I backed myself right up out of there, Rusty, real slow and easy, and talked real nice to him, Rusty. Well, I don't blame it all, Ralph. Them things are scary. They're big. To a little fella like you, they're huge. We got one big hill going up out of here. I don't assume it's going to be any trouble, though. It goes uphill for a long ways up here. Up to where we get to Sky Bridge. They got a set of bathrooms made up there with locking doors and garbage can with the handles on the lid so the bears can't figure out how to open the handles. And a lot of stuff like that. But if you want to go on an adventure and you like climbing rocks and kayaking and sleeping in the woods and walking hundreds of miles of trails, hiking is your thing, this is your place right here. You can see the river over to the right still winding around boulders and stuff. There's another parking place you can park. I've stopped there a lot on my motorcycle and looked around. Somewhere in here you can see Chimney Rock. I don't know where it is. You can see Sky Bridge from one place, but I don't remember exactly where that is either. This time of year when the leaves is off, you can see it, and in the summertime you can't see it. You just have to look over to the right up on top of those mountains there. You can see all kinds of stuff over there. Now, I think right here is where it starts uphill for a while. I used to about ride my motorcycle around here. About every second, third time we'd get it out, we'd go around this way to take off, then go somewhere else from here. Check out what was going on down in here. These roads are really slick. You can't tell it, though. The old Jeep's doing good. I need those tires, Duck. Those was wore out.
Yeah, it sure was. I told you about doing it, you know.
Yeah, I know you told me to get some.
Yeah,
at least he listened to you, Duck.
Yeah,
well, that's a crooked river. If they straighten that thing out, it wouldn't be half as long, would it? Had my camera shoved all the way up on top GoPro camera shoved all the way up against the windshield on the little box so it wouldn't vibrate so much. It's just sitting there in the center of the windshield. GoPro cameras, those are nice. You can put a waterproof case on them and put them underwater. Anything. You can do anything with those. I was thinking about getting a headlight out of a car and wiring it up to a pole and make it waterproof so it don't get electrocuted. Stick it underwater with a GoPro camera under it. On it and let it shine, fish will come to a big bright light underwater. Stick it underwater and see if I can film some big catfish or something coming up. They say the catfish in this river down here are big enough to swallow a fella. I don't believe it, but they say they are. They put divers in down when they built the boat lock to check things out, and the diver said there's some of the awfulest fish they ever seen down in there. I've seen some mighty big ones, but I don't think they're big enough to swallow up a fella, sure to not. Now, they're a big rock you go over and sit on and tan in the summertime when you're riding your little kayak through there. Nah, I never could ride a kayak, Rusty. I was upside down more than I was right side up. Like to drown it, but I had to wear a snorkel for me to ride a kayak there, Rusty. My balance, I got some bad balance there, Rusty. Yeah, me too. My front half's a lot heavier than the back there, Rusty. Ralph. My belly got me overweighted there, you think? Yeah, it looks that way, Rusty. It looks that way. You're going to have to start doing some setups there, about 7,500 of them or something, Rusty. Thank you, Ralph. I just thought I'd make this video to show you some of my country here, what Kentucky looks like when the leaves are off the trees in the wintertime and the white snow and rocky mountains and roads, trees almost growing in the highway. No guardrails, just straight over the cliff if you run off the road and that kind of good stuff. But you'll like that tunnel, rewatch that tunnel at the first two or three times. That's a really nice tunnel. For some reason it's hard to ride a motorcycle through. You can get in there and the headlight shines, it makes it look funny in there on a motorcycle, and it makes you want to wobble for some reason. One person wouldn't ride his through. He got off, let somebody else ride it through. But I've rode through many, many times on it. But some way when you get in there, it just sort of some kind of illusion or something makes you feel like you're wobbling from one side of the road to the other. Cars getting battles in that tunnel all the time they go in there. You can't see cars coming at either end till you get inside the tunnel. And they both get in the tunnel, nobody wants to back up. But there's a nice rock. You ever wonder how it gets there? That's what I ask the wife all the time. And she says, well, no, I don't wonder where and how no rock got anywhere. I said, when you see a big wide open field and there's no rocks anywhere and all of a sudden you see a rock big as a house sitting right down there in the middle of the field, don't you ever wonder how come that rock's out there? She said, nope. I got a curious mind. I like to know that kind of stuff. It didn't grow there unless somebody's farming rock. Nah, farming rock, Rusty, farming rock, you know better than that. You know better than that kind of stuff. Nobody does that. It takes too long to grow them, Rusty. Two, three people die before the rock got good size. You think, Ral? Yeah, I think it'd be a waste of time out of Rusty. I think you crazy, Ral. Nah, same here, Rusty, same here about you. This is what we do on our day off, people, when we ain't driving our 18-wheeler. We drive around and look and see if we can find some kayakers in bathing suits riding up and down the river. But I guess right now it wouldn't be a good day to find that. I guess we'd have to come on a sunny day for that. We'd have to come out here on a sunny day and check all that stuff out. There are a lot of good looking people down here in tent days and camping and swimming and hiking and all that kind of stuff. Good place to ride your motorcycle through. And sometimes they got these real old car collections from Ohio. They drive all the way down from Ohio, like Model T's. All kinds of them, and they'll come through that tunnel all at once. I've been over there with my motorcycle and have to wait till they get through. You park there, and they got an escort bringing them through, and there'll be about 50 or 75 of those old cars that drove all the way from Ohio down here to drive through this. And there's another rest area with little bathrooms and stuff. Here's a little bridge, here's a little tiny bridge. But anyway, they drive them old Model T cars down here, and they drive through here, and they also ride bicycles. A group of those bicycle fellers rides around here once a year with escorts. About 200-300 bicycles raising money rides through here. Busy, busy little place, Red River Gorge, Eastern Kentucky. Now this is the hill goes up here. And we go out this way, if we could stop, we won't though, but if you could stop in all these wide places and look over to your right here and left, you can see for miles because you're up on top of the mountain now. A beautiful scenery. They got little wide places you can stop and walk out and look over concrete walls. It's great scenery to check out what's going on and stuff. Like right there is a parking spot. Right over there to the left's one. But you go and check out the scenery on it. And you can see what's going on over in there. I should have turned the camera around, but apparently I don't. Should have turned the camera around and checked out the top of these mountains here for you. Yeah, that's right, Rusty. That's right. You should have showed them around, Rusty, instead of just driving in the snow. I thought they might want to take a ride in the snow. Those people live in Texas and all those fine places that don't get to see much snow. See right there on the left's overlook. You park there and look over the mountain. A lot of those places like that. One place up here I can show you sometime. I'll take a video. It's got a natural, perfect round nose in it. Look like they're big as a house. Look like a cave. It's got perfect round holes. Now right here, see the road kind of splits, and you got a look over right there where you can see, you can get there and see forever. Look like it's straight down drop. You can see the top of trees down in the hole. We've not got very far to go now. You get up here and you'll come to right about here somewhere. Maybe a little further. You come up on the last rest area just before you get to the Sky Bridge, and that's the end of this road, and you have to go back out. You're supposed to stop and go walk across Sky Bridge and enjoy the view. Now right here's the end. There's the outside of the locked up bathrooms, and there's the locked up garbage cans with handles that nobody can bother. The bears can't open, and here's a little loop you can go down here, and I can't go down here and park, but you can turn. You have to park up there by the bathrooms to walk to Sky Bridge, and Sky Bridge is just out of sight down that path right there. Nice place to go visit. So we'll head back out this way a little bit and we'll be about done. Next time I go, I'll put my helmet and my... There's some deers out in my yard, so we're done with the trip. So, thank everybody for watching. This has been the Duck and Truck Show. We're trying to show you a little bit of nature. Now, this right here is out in my yard. There's five deers, a lot of them bucks, a little bit of pointed horns there. But they come out to my house every day and wild turkey. So we'll see you next time. Rusty Truck. And your best friend Ralph. We'll see y'all next time, man. Catch you on the flip flop. We're out of here. Bye bye.